That perfect pitch is the sound of a banjo falling on an accordion in the bottom of a dumpster. That's, I don't know if you've ever heard that, but that's, I've heard that. In fact, I just heard it right then. I do want to tell you something. Ray and I are singing with a couple of other guys that we went to college with. Lived right across the hall from me in the dormitory in my freshman year and everything. And we decided that it would be fun. We had been spread to the four corners of the earth, and we got back together and all lived back in Kansas City now. And we thought, let's see what we can do. Maybe we could make a recording. And we did. So I have CDs. Ray has CDs. In fact, we agreed between the two of us that whoever gives away the most CDs at this camp gets a set of steak knives. So I'm way behind. Okay, I'm way behind. And so if you would like, by any chance, one of these CDs, I have some. And just say so, and I'd love for you to have it. They're really fun. We're going to do a song right now that is going to be a new experience for me. If you're singing with Ray and if you're singing with Jim, the most important things you know immediately are that the lead and the tenor are covered. You got it done. So this will be the very first experience I have ever had, literally ever had, in front of other people singing other than tenor. So I'm singing the low part tonight. So this will be an adventure for us all. I hope it works out. Thank you. Well, I think we can agree that Larry has, there will be new parts for him in the future with his group. That he did that great, sounded terrific. All right, we have, gosh, how many people are getting up here? A lot of people getting on the stage for this song, and I'm looking forward to it because it has our first time camper, Sydney Adams.
Hello, check.
Yeah.
Are we ready? Okay, this song is written by Roxy Dean, and I sang another one a couple of nights ago, done by her. It is about anyone that has a mother. Okay.
Raise your hand.
Yes.
Some of you aren't sure.
Right. Yeah.
And now for all you youngsters out there, right here on our stage, the leader of the, well, a member of the Elderly Brothers, world famous singing group from suburban Philadelphia, Stan Scheckman.
Good evening, gatherers. We used to be called campers, but we're gatherers now. Any hunters out there? Yes. In the first set, I was quite moved by Steve Rich's song, and over the years it's been a tradition to honor those of you who have served our country. Could you stand and be recognized? Elderly Brothers in the Philadelphia area. Tom has a group called the Elderly Brothers Trio in the Detroit area. And we just got a request for a gig right before camp. We were very thrilled. And then we saw the phone number, and it was from New Hampshire. So hello to the Elderly Brothers in New Hampshire. tonight, the FLT does ELP. This is a song by Emerson, Lake, and Palmer. And we're back. Oh, here we go. And the song was written by Greg Lake when he was 13 years old. And Carl Palmer, the drummer, is the only surviving member. This is a song about a lucky man. Man, he was. of his honor and his glory. The people, they would sing, ooh, what a lucky man he was. Ooh, what a lucky man he was. A bull had found him. His blood ran as he cried. No money could save him, so he lay down and he died. Ooh, what a lucky man he was. Ooh, what a lucky man he was.
Thanks, Stan, for the plug about our group. Believe me, the way the bookings are going, we need it. Those of you who were here last night may remember that John Birchler did a beautiful version of Mike Nesmith's Joanne. And John is back here again. Here he is.
Broken hearts in 1967, as I did, because the Kingston Trio broke up. And in 1969, things started to get better because I came home from my summer job and turned on the radio and heard, la da 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 da. Oh my God, that's John Stewart. So this is that song, July. Here it was. Everybody ready?
Ready.
2, 3, 4. I can't hold it on the road when you're sitting right beside me and I'm drunk out of my mind merely from the fact that you are here. And I have not been known as the saint of San Joaquin, and I'd just as soon right now go on over to the side of the road and show you what I mean. La da 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 da, sing if you want to. La da 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 da. July, you're a woman more than anyone I've ever known. And I can't hold my eyes on the white line on before me when your hand is on my collar and you're talking in my ear.
All right. We're going to a couple more songs and we have something special. But this next song is going to be interesting because Jerry Martyr is going to sing, and he's got some terrific backup vocalists with him. But Jerry asked me what he should do, whether he should do a couple of song choices. And I happen to be a huge fan of Ronnie Millsaps. So Jerry asked me if he could do this, or I asked him if he would do it. So please welcome Jerry Martyr. That was great. You know, it's not often you get a member of the Diamonds and a member of the Rat-a-Tats on the stage at one time. I think the Rat-a-Tats, weren't they inducted into some Hall of Fame? The Hall of Shame. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's it. Okay, we got one more camper performance tonight, and this is going to take the show, take us out on a note, and then we're going to have a little mini couple of special guests going to do something for us after this. Please welcome Julie Spire Murphy with a little help from her friends.
Mary Spire also coming up to join me. So I picked this song because it says everything I feel about this gathering of people. We come up here, we might not always know the notes, but we encourage each other. And over time, over all the years that I've been coming, I have seen all of us just grow in our abilities and in our affection for each other. And it means the world to me. So thank you. This is a little help from my friends. All right. Super. I have some really, really good friends up here, by the way. It doesn't get any better than this. I've got goosebumps. I'm really excited. Ready?
That was great. All right, that was our final performance from the group from the Gatherers, but we do have a special guest tonight. This group, most of it, performed with us last year, and we really enjoyed having them. And I got to say, there's not a better person that I've ever met than Greg Deering. I mean, he's just one of the sweetest guys in the world. And is so supportive of us and everything that we do. So he'll fill you in on the group. But here they are: Deering, Learned, Prim, and Prim. Woo!
Jeff said, there's three banjos on the stage right now.
No one's safe.
Everything we do up here and everything about the music is about the banjo. My wife Janet and I started Deering Banjo Company 48 years ago. And we're somewhere north of 175,000 banjos we've made. We didn't set out to build 175,000 banjos. We set out to do our very best to make some magic, to make things special for people. And we've been working hard on it. I think we're doing pretty good at making things magic. But I wanted to bring that up, not to talk about Deering Banjos, but to talk about John and Tony and Kent and the music I got to make with these gentlemen back in the days before Deering Banjo Company. It's the magic and the energy I got to experience with these guys.
Leave it. Just leave
provided
it.
The foundation that became Deering Banjo Company. Without these guys, I can't tell you for sure Deering Banjo Company would be there. And we were the core of song service at the church where we went. Little tiny church called the Pioneer United Church of Christ. And we did this song service every Sunday at 8:30 in the morning for 3.5 years. And when I say we did it, we did it. I had to do the sermon. We did all the music. And it was amazing that the church turned us loose to do whatever we wanted. And that was part of the magic too, Sunday after Sunday, coming up with the material. But it was an example of when you're doing your best, you always have to pay attention to what you're doing in present time, because whatever you do in present time, you're creating your future. And at the time, I didn't know it, but one of the young ladies that was out in the congregation eventually went on to become my wife. Didn't know it at the time, but that these guys helped me win her over Sunday at a time. Even on top of that, the young lady that became Tony's wife was out there.
She's out there. Can I say something? Can I say something? So I don't know why I wanted to do this next song, because my brother is great at singing in Spanish, but he refused to give the interpretation of the words of this song. I don't know why, but I got an interpretation, and it's a love song to a girl. But the girl that I'm thinking of is my wife, Jessie. The girl he's thinking of, his wife, Janet. The girl he's thinking of is his wife, Jeanette. And the girl he's thinking of is Lee. And three of them are here tonight. So this is for them. So we need all of you. I know you're all really good singers, and you did this for the Krueger brothers, so we want you to do it for us. When the chorus comes, please sing out, okay? Thank you.
yo mi fuerte hecha, el arroyo de la sierra me complace más que Guantanamera, Guajira, Guantanamera.
Spanish. Pero desafortunadamente, de vez en cuando tengo que hacerlo. Pero que yo, es que soy yo. Okay? Anyway, actually, I speak Spanish in a funny way. I don't know if you noticed. Most people sing that Guantanamera, right? It actually is how they do it in Sonora, Mexico, because they make that G-U-E sound like a W. But in regular Spanish, in other words, the rest of the world, it's a hard G. Guantanamera. Guajira. Anyway, that's your Spanish lesson for the day. So hasta la vista, baby.
This is a song that we wrote, my brother and I, when we were in high school, I believe.
I think like 15, 14.
Very young.
It's called Lucky Man. I'm just kidding.
But it's kind of a protest song.
Not protest. No, it's a song about the desire for peace.
Yes.
And the world is messed up. Would you agree with me?
Yeah.
We need some peace right now. And I mean, we need to have a place where we're not worried about things that are going on, disasters and the way that people act and the cruelty in the world and the disenfranchisement. And I had a list here earlier I was going to share, but you know what I'm talking about, right? And this song is, you know what, it's juvenile in the lyrics. And I know that because the juveniles that wrote it are up here, okay? But I want you to know that the heart of it was, even a young guy, along with his young brother, understood that peace is something that is sought after and often never found. So this is a hope. This is a hope that someday we can find it. It's called In the Late of Dawn. Where have you gone?
like darkness does. But why can't we see those who try to fly? Where will it end? We must not stop to cry. We stand and we watch, and we watch them all go by. But why? Where have they gone through streams of mist with fire just breaking through? With streams of mist with fire just breaking through? But why can't we see those who try but die? Where will it end? We must not stop to cry. We stand and we watch, and we watch them all go by. But why?